similar to this one, but let's have a look at the same. And here at the back, it gives us some specs that is powered by the Snapdragon 425 chipset, which is a quad-core processor. I'll just keep the handset to the side for now. We'll come back to this later, and we'll also compare it with the Redmi 4A and some paperwork and stuff that you're getting. Surprising, and SIM ejector tool and micro USB to USB cable. So let's keep this thing to the side and then let's have a look at it. As you can see, this is the handset, and it's slightly, it's very similar to this one. So the corners are slightly more rounded on this one, that's what I'm noticing. Having the IR blaster, which is a nice thing. I like that Sony doesn't have that. We have the volume rockers and power on a button. It feels like it's metallic, guys, but it's not. It is plastic coated. This entire rim is actually plastic coated, not metallic. Micro USB port, main microphone, and two slots over here. That is sent to. So dedicated two SIM cards, you can put an SD card on this micro SD card. So that's a nice thing. And let's just try to boot this up now. And by the time it boots up and I set it up, let me give you a confirmation. It's Redmi 5A as a 5 and 10 HP. It has a Redmi 4GPU. It comes with 2 variants, 2 GB RAM and 4 3 GB RAM. It's a boot up and dedicated micro SD card slot. Main to the camera, it has a 30 MP rear facing camera and a 5 MP front facing camera. And it has a 3000 mAh battery. So I've just finished setting up this device. Again, as expected, the typical media that we're getting. So if you're using a Xiaomi device, you should be familiar with this. It has the auto brightness sensor. And also has that new remote that you can see what the unlocked version that you get. Tray are not backlit, and as you can see, the one that we are having right now is the 2 GB RAM variant, and on that one, out of that 16 GB, only 8.37 GB is available. So I would say this much is actually pretty low. So if you are planning to purchase this device, opt for the 2 GB RAM variant. Internal storage, though it is a lot. performance should be very similar to the Redmi 4A because the processor is almost the same on this one. Again, this one also does not have any fingerprint scanner. So if you want fingerprint scanner, you have to opt for the micro variant on the Redmi 4A. This one. And let's consider trying to now fire up the camera. I don't expect a lot of Xiaomi is not famous for itself, and let's be frank about that. Like, we have the tap to focus, but I immediately noticed that the exposure, as you notice right now, it's decent exposure, but if you tap in, the exposure is actually going to tell in the screen. But anyways, here are some of the snaps that I have taken with this below. And if you have any other specific questions, again, do post them in the comment section. I'll try to include them in the other videos that I have. And if you're still not subscribed to